Highway Engineering. Highway Engineering Model 1. So in this model, Principles of Transportation Engineering, Importance of Transportation, Different Modes of Transportation and Comparison, Characteristics of Road Transport, GECR Committee Recommendations and Implementations, Central Road Fund, Indian Road Congress, Central Road Research Institute. Highway Development and Planning. Road Types and Classification, Road Pattern, Planning Survey, Master Planning, Saturation System, Road Development in India, Problems on the above. Apart from this, KSHIP, KRDCL and present scenario of road development in India. Principles of Transportation Engineering. Importance, characteristics of road, different modes of transportation. Characteristics of road transportation. Roads are used by various types of roadways. Road transport requires a relatively small investment to the government. Road transport offers a complete freedom to road users to transfer the vehicle from one lane to another and from one road to another according to the need and convenience. In particular, for short distance travel, road transport saves time. Speed of movement is directly related with severity of accidents. Road transport is the only means of transport that offers itself to the whole community. So these are the points which characterize the road transport system or the characteristics of road transportation. Now, importance of roads in India. Importance in the sense, significance of the planned road network, requirement of the rural road development, comparative study of road statistics. In importance of road transportation, you can have social importance, economical importance, and infrastructural importance. Now, the comparative study of road statistics. First of all, there was no planned development of road in the country up to initiation of Nagpur Road Plan in 1943. The investment given today on road development program is much lower. Poor economic condition of the vast majority of population in villages prohibit the owning of the private vehicle and discourage the use of transportation. Now these are the importance and comparative study of road statistics. Bhaiya full screen hai wo. Full screen hai na. Ye full screen hai wo. Now we'll see the GECR committee recommendations. फुल स्क्रीन हो रही है. अच्छा वरी धर अच्छा वरी धर असते जयकार कमिटी रेकमेंडेशन आनी तेवने रे. द जयकार कमिटी सबमिटेड इट्स रिपोर्ट इन 1928. द इम्पॉर्टेंट रेकमेंडेशन्स मेड बाय जयकार कमिटी आर रोड डेवलपमेंट in the country should be considered a national interest. An extra tax should be levied on petrol from the road users to develop the road development fund called Central Road Fund. A semi-official technical body should be formed to pour technical know-how from various parts of country and to act as an advisory body. A research organization should be initiated to carry out research and development work and to be available for consultation. So these are the gecraichur committee recommendations. हे एक पेज है आणि पुढं नाहीतर तिथूनच झूम कर. नाही तर पुढं रे मागल पूर्ण काय घेऊ नये हे एवढंच दिसाव आणि असे हायवे डेव्हलपमेंट अँड प्लॅनिंग टाईप्स ऑफ रोड्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेदर कंडिशन टू टाईप्स ऑफ रोड्स ऑल वेदर रोड्स फेअर वेदर रोड्स based on carriageway, paved roads, unpaved roads, based on types of pavement, surface road, unsurface road. These are the types of roads based on depending on weather condition, based on carriageway, based on type of pavement. Classification of roads, methods of classification. So based on the traffic volume, based on the road, load transported, tonnage and location and function. Now apart from this, Nagpur road plan classification is there. In this, road is classified as national highways denoted by NH, state highways SH, major district road MDH, other district road ODH, village road VR. Then third road development plan classified the road as primary system roads, territory system roads or rural roads and secondary system. In primary system, expressways, national highways. In secondary system, state highway, major district road. In territory system, other district roads and village roads. Now classification of urban roads. RTL roads, sub-arterial roads, collector street roads, local roads. Now we'll move to road pattern. Road patterns may be rectangular block pattern, radial star pattern. You can see in this figure, this is the rectangular block pattern, this is star and block pattern, this is radial circular pattern. याच्यावर झूम कर. दिस इज रेडियल स्टार अँड ग्रीड पॅटर्न. दिस इज हेक्सागोनल पॅटर्न. नाव वील मूव टू सम टू कॅल्क्युलेट दी लेंथ ऑफ रोड. देर इज सम नागपूर रोड डेव्हलपमेंट प्लॅन इन विच लेंथ ऑफ द रोड कॅन बी कॅल्क्युलेटेड. So before calculation of the length of the road, certain formulas are there to calculate the national highway length, state highway length, major district roads. So this is Nagpur road plan. So in this Nagpur road plan, total length of road for NH and SH formula. This is first category formula, NH, SH plus MDR in kilometers. It is given by A by 8 plus B by 32 plus 1.6N plus 8T plus D minus R. A is agricultural area in square kilometer. B is non-agricultural area in square kilometer. N is number of towns and villages with population range 2001 to 5000. T is number of towns and villages with population range over 5000. D is development allowance of 15% of road length. R is existing length of railway track in kilometers. That was for NH and SH. Now total length of ODR, that is other district roads and village road formula. It is also known as secondary category formula. ODR plus VR in kilometers is equal to 0.32V plus 0.8Q plus 1.6P plus 3.2S plus D. V is number of villages with population 500 or less. Q is number of villages with population 501 to 1000. P is number of villages with population 1001 to 2000. S is number of villages with population 2000 to 5000. D is development allowance of 15% for next 20 years. Now let us see the problems based on to calculate the length of road for national highway, state highway, other district roads and village roads. So this is the example. The following data were calculated for planning the road development for backward districts. Total area 9600 km square. Agriculture development 3200 km square. Existing railway track length 105 km square. Existing length of metal road 322 km. Number of towns in different population range, it is given here. Population and number of villages. Greater than 5000, number of villages are 8. 2001 to 5000, number of villages are 40. 1001 to 2000, number of villages 130. 501 to 1000, 280. Less than 500, 590. Now this is the given data. That is total area, agriculture development, existing railway, existing length of metal road, existing length of unmetal road, number of towns in different villages. Now we have to calculate the total length of national highways and state highways. So first we have to note down the given data. A is agricultural developed land. 3200 km square. B is non-agricultural, that is 9600 minus this agricultural 6400. R is existing length of railway track 105 km square. N is equal to number of villages 40, that is existing 2001 to 5000. T is equal to 8. T is another T. Now the formula for to calculate the national highway, state highway plus major district road is A by 8 plus B by 32, 1.6N plus 8T plus D minus R. So substitute the values got here in this formula. Plus D is 15% of total length minus R is length of existing length of railway track 105. So this 15% of total length is 728 into 15 divided by 100. So minus 105 you will get total length of NH, SH plus MDR. Now additional metal road, it is 732.2 minus 322. 322 existing length of metal rod. It is given in problem. Existing length of metal rod, we have to subtract from this. We will get the additional metal rod. Now secondary category rod. It is 0.32V plus 0.8Q plus 1.6P plus 3.2S plus D. Now given data is number of V is number of villages with population range. It is 590 given in problem. Q is number of villages with population range 501 to 1000. It is 280. It is given. P is number of villages population range from 1001 to 2000. It is given 130. S is 40, D is 15% of total length. Now substitute in this formula V, Q, P and S plus 15% of total length. We will get 861 kilometers. Now additional unmetalled road required is 861 minus 450. 450 is number of existing length of unmetalled road is 450. You will get this. Now that was the national highway length, state highway length, other district road and major district road. These are the formulas for 20-year road development plan. Five formulas are there. So five formulas for national highway plus state highway, national highway plus state highway plus MDR, national highway plus state highway plus MDR plus ODR, SH, NH, SH plus MDR, ODR plus VR. So these are the formulas. So same A, B, C, K, M are indicated here. Now based on these formulas, can calculate the length of road. This is another example. You can go through the notes. So neat kenas bhaiya ye cheo re ikadle ye kabar yole le thebak ye
to tuchki
nuste odas kar tu kabar gadbad kar le te sagle eta bag shiva de ata. Now this complete model 1. So in model 1, you have seen the principles of transportation engineering and highway development and planning. So in which KSHIP and KRDCL is given, we will explain it at last. Hello? Okay, what is your road? Now, pavement material. So, in pavement material, you are going to see subgrade soil, desirable properties, HRB classification of soil, determination of CBR and modulus of subgrade reaction with examples, aggregates, desirable properties of aggregates, list of tests on the aggregates, bituminous material, explanation on tar, bitumen, cutback, emulsion, and list of tests on bituminous material. Now we will go to subgrade soil. Significance of subgrade soil. So subgrade soil is an integral part of road pavement structure as it provides the support to the pavement from beneath. The main function is to give adequate support to the pavement. It should possess sufficient stability under adverse climate and loading conditions. Characteristics of soil. Soil consists of mineral matter formed by disintegration of rocks, by the action of water, frost, temperature, pressure, by plants or animal life. Depends on size shape, surface texture and chemical composition. So these are the desirable properties of soil: stability, incompressibility, permanency of strength, minimum change in volume and stability under adverse condition of weather and groundwater, good drainage system, easy of compaction. Now there are various classification of soils. Method of classification of soils are there, like structure method is there, compound method is there, Casagrande method is there, California method is there. So for our syllabus, Highway Research Board classification of soil is important, that is HRB classification of soil. Now what is, let us see what is this HRB classification of soil. Highway Research Board classification of soil. So in this, soil is divided into soil group, subsoil group, general stability properties of subgrade material, maximum drainage density is taken, CBR percentage is taken, subgrade modulus is taken, drainage characteristics is taken, volume change is taken and potential frost action is there. So soil group is A1, A3, A2, A4, A5, A6 and A7. In subgroup A1A, A1B, A24, A25, A26, A27, A3. So in general, for A1 group, A1A, high stability very good soil, it is excellent subgrade soil. Maximum dry density is 2.03, CBR value is 60 to 90%, subgrade modulus is greater than 8.33, drainage characteristics is excellent to good, volume change nothing, potential frost action none to slight. So like this, A1, A3, A2, A4, A5, A6, A7, all the characteristics are given in this table. पूरा झाल तर भी बस तसं जायसारखं दिसत दोन मॉडेल झालं की जा नंतर तिथंच कर. डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ CBR व्हॅल्यू. CBR मीन्स कॅलिफोर्निया बेअरिंग रेशो टेस्ट. सो इन दिस टेस्ट वी आर हॅविंग CBR सेट अपरेटस. याला जरा झूम कर. सो इन दिस सेटअप अपरेटस CBR mold is there. This is the penetration type of test, in which this is the mold surcharge weight of 147 kgs. This mold is having a height of 127.3 meters height. This is the probing ring and this is penetration ring. So this setup will be there for determination of CBR value. So it is a penetration type of test developed by California Division of Highways. Test results are correlated with flexible pavement. So apparatus consists of 150 mm diameter base plate and collar. Loading frame will be there. Dial gauges will be there. So in this CBR, brief theory of this CBR. Penetration test consists of a cylindrical plunger, 500 mm diameter to penetration a pavement material of 1.25 mm per minute. The load values cause 2.5 mm and 5 mm penetration. These loads are expressed in percentage of standard load values at respective deformation level. The standard load values obtained from average of large number of tests on crushed stones are 1370 and 2055 kg respectively at 2.5 and 5 mm penetration. Now this is the procedure to carry out the CBR test. The specimen in the mold is subjected to 4 days soaking and the swelling and watering observation values are noted. The surcharge weight is placed on the top of the specimen in the mold and the assembly is placed under the plunger. The loads values are noted, corresponding values of 0.0, 0.5, 1.5 up to 12.5 mm. The load penetration graph is plotted. Alternative load values is converted to the pressure value. So here in graph sheet, load versus penetration values are plotted and points are joined. And for 2.5 mm, what is the load? And for 5 mm, what is the load? We can calculate. CBR calculator is done by CBR is equal to load or pressure sustained by the specimen at 2.5 and 5 mm penetration divided by load or pressure sustained by the aggregates at corresponding penetration level. I will do one problem on this CBR. The load penetration values of CBR test conducted on specimen are given below. You should determine the values of soil. If 100 divisions of load dial represents 190 kg load in the calculation chart of probing ring, penetration of plunger in mm 0 to 12.5, load dials for specimen 1 0 to 0, 8, 15, 23, 29, 34, 37, 43, 48, 59, 63, 67. Then for specimen 2 load dial gauge reading 0.5, 1.5, 2.5, 6.0, 13, 20, 30, 38, 50, 58, 63. Now for calculating, first we will draw the graph penetration versus load versus penetration. For specimen 1, load for penetration of plunger and load will get this type of curve, that is for specimen 1. For specimen 2, this type of curve will get. So this graph is for load versus penetration. Now we will calculate the load at 2.5 mm penetration. For 2.5 mm, the load is 34 into 190. 190 is the load dial gauge reading divided by 164, and CBR value load at penetration 64.6 divided by, this is the standard value for the load of aggregate standard value 1370 into 100. Similarly, load at 5 mm penetration 48 into 190 divided by 100, you will get this, and CBR value 91.2 divided by 2055 into 100. You will get these values. So like this you can calculate the CBR value, and highest of these two values is considered as CBR of that sample. So in pavement design chapter, types of pavement, component parts of flexible pavement, component parts of rigid pavement, functional parts, functions of component parts, ESL, ESWL and its determination of problems. Flexible pavement, design of flexible pavement by IRC 37, design of rigid pavement is by IRC 58. Now before designing, we will consider what are the objectives and requirement of pavement. Objectives of pavement are: the surface of roadway should be stable and non-yielding. Road surface should be even. The pavement causes the wheel load and they transfer the load stresses through a wider area on soil subgrade below to keep the elastic deformation of pavement within the permissible limits. Now types of pavement structures. So based on the structural behavior, pavements are flexible pavement and rigid pavement. Flexible pavements are those which on the whole have low negligible flexural strength. Flexible pavement layer reflects the deformation of lower layer on the surface of layer. Thus, if lower layer is undulated, the flexural pavement surface also gets undulated. Now we'll see the component parts of flexible pavement. So this is the figure for flexible pavement layers. You can draw it in another way also. So bottom layer is soil subgrade. This is soil subgrade. Then subbase course. This is subbase course layer. Then base course. Then surface course. So another way of drawing this layers is subgrade, GSB or granular subgrade, wet mix macadam and bituminous concrete. Now functions of flexible pavement component layers. The flexible component layers transmit the vertical compressive stress to the lower layers by grain to grain transfer through the points of contact in granular structure. Well compacted granular structure consists of strong graded aggregates which can transfer the compressive stress through a wider area. The load spreading ability of this layer depends on type of material and mix design. Other materials are WBM crust aggregates, gravel, soil aggregates, mix. Now rigid pavement. So in rigid pavement, component parts are soil subgrade, base course, cement concrete slab. The design factors considered for flexible pavement are design wheel load, pavement component material, subgrade soil, special factors, climatic factors, environment factors. For us, equivalent single wheel load design of flexible pavement is important. So in this figure, the dual wheel load ESW, it is called equivalent single wheel load. Wheels are drawn, dual wheels are there. So these dual wheels are approximately loading on the surface of the pavement, and the stresses are overlapped due to the dual works. That means stresses are compressed on the top of the surface of pavement, and these stresses can be analyzed by taking the stress overlap due to wheel works. It is a typical figure of equivalent single wheel load. So here we have to give the clear gap between the center of the wheels. Spacing should be considered, clear gap should be considered, and radius of circular area or contact area it can be considered in this approximate point in this single equivalent single wheel load concept. So dual wheel load is considered. S can be taken as the spacing between the centers of the wheel, D is the clear gap between the center of the wheels, and 2S means two spacings can be considered here. So these are pointing towards downward direction. These are also stress which are overlapping, and at a approximate point of overlapping can be considered. And we can clearly see this equivalent single wheel load figure, and this figure is explained here. The load depression is assumed at an angle of 45 degree with dual load assembly. D is the clear gap between center of wheels, S the spacing between center of wheels, A is the radius of circular contact area. then S is given by D plus 2A. Up to the depth of D by 2, each wheel load will have a P as a load, acts immediately, and after there, the stresses induced due to the each load begin to develop. At depth 2S and above, the stress induced are due to the effect of both wheels of magnitude. It is for single wheel, it is 2P. For dual wheel, it is 2P. The total stresses due to the dual wheel at any depth greater than 2S is considered to be the ESWL. Now, this concept can be understood by calculating one load and the spacing by deriving the equation and by calculating the load and spacing formula. So, this formula is there. Calculate the equivalent single wheel load of a given dual wheel assembly carrying a wheel load of P is equal to 2044 kg, each for pavement thickness 15, 20, 25 cm center to center. Tire spacing is 27 cm. Between walls, spacing of tires is 11 cm. P is 2044, it is given. Pavement thickness is 15, 20, 25. Spacing is 27 cm. Wall spacing of tire D is 11 cm. 2P means double of this. 2S means double of S, 54 cm. D by 2 is 5.5. So X has a coordinates P and D by 2. Y has a coordinates 2P and 2S. P is 2044, D by 2 is 5.5, 2P is 4088, 2S is 54. Now, you will draw a graph in the log sheet or logarithm sheet, taking on x-axis ESWL and y-axis thickness. Thickness 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. For thickness, first X is P and 2S. X is P and D by 2, Y is 2P and 2S. So in this log sheet, first we will point out X and Y, P and D by 2, Y is 2S and D by 2S and P, and join these points with a straight line, these two points. Then for whatever thickness you want, you can calculate the ESWL values. So pavement thickness of 15 cm, what is the ESWL value? Pavement thickness of 20, what is the ESWL value? Thickness of 25, what is ESWL value? So like this, for pavement thickness of 15, we are getting ESWL as 27460, for 20, 3000, for 25, 3230. It is a simple problem. So for 6M syllabus, you can see only pavement types, components, parts of flexible and rigid pavement and their functions. ESWL determination, graphical method. Up to this you are having in pavement design. Now next model is pavement construction. Pause kar. Harita? Pavement construction. In pavement construction, you are going to see different types of pavement layers, how they are constructed. First one is earthwork, in cutting, filling, preparation of subgrade specification, construction of granule subgrade, waterborne macadam, wet mix macadam, bituminous concrete, dense bituminous concrete, dry lean concrete, and concrete roads. So the selection of base course and subgrade course depend on the following factors: type and intensity of traffic, funds availability, subgrade soil and drainage condition, availability of construction material at site, climatic condition, plants and equipments available, time available for completing the project, altitude of which construction has to be done. The highway construction is divided into two phases, earthwork and preparation of subgrade and main pavement structure. First we will see construction of embankment. So in this, design elements are height, fill material, settlement, stability of foundation, stability of slopes. Embankment is required to raise the grade line of highway above the existing road level. The grade line will be raised due to the following reasons: to keep the subgrade above high ground level, to prevent damage to the pavement due to the surface water, and to maintain the design standards of highway. Design elements: height, fill material, these are all the design elements you can go through. So this is the typical section of a embankment in which the horizontal sand blankets are given, compressible layer is there, 40 to 60 centimeter thickness. This horizontal sand blankets are there, in which vertical sand drains are also there and hard morum is there. And to accelerate the rate of consolidation, vertical sand drains are constructed. These are vertical columns of sand installed in sand drains in a compressible foundation in order to decrease the drainage path and to increase the rate of consolidation spacing. Horizontal sand blanket of 42 to 60 cm thick is placed at the top of the trace all along the width of the embankment. Stability of foundation is there, then stability of slopes are there. So here, construction of earthwork. The specification of material is given as per IRC. Soil specification: clay content should be less than 5% for base course, 10 to 18% for weaving course, silt content 9 to 32% for base course, 5 to 15% for weaving course, sand 60 to 80%, 65 to 80%, liquid limit less than 35, here is all less than 35, plasticity index less than 6%. So these are the specification of material for soil. Now the construction procedure. Material, you have seen the material specification. The soil survey is carried out and suitable borrow pits are located within the economical visible distance. The borrow pits are usually selected outside the land width. Trees, shrubs, grass roots and even top soil level are removed before excavation. Location: the center line and road edges are not on the ground along the alignment by driving wooden pegs. Reference pegs are also driven for the vertical profile of the road. Spacing depends on the road length. Now these are the four steps: material, location, preparation of subgrade and pavement construction. So in preparation of pavement grade, clearing the site, excavating and construction of fills, shaping the subgrade. Pavement construction: the borrowed soil is dumped on the prepared subgrade and pulverized. The fill moisture content is checked and water is added or removed to bring up the optimum moisture content. Now the soil is mixed and spread and rolled in the layer such that the thickness of each layer will not exceed 10 cm. The camber slope is finished for the pavement is checked, and the opening to traffic. The compacted earth road is allowed to dry out for few days and open to the traffic. Construction of gravel roads. So this is type of gravel surface you will see. Construction procedure: material, location, preparation of subgrade, opening to traffic. Construction of preparation of subgrade, opening to traffic. All these steps are given here. Then construction of WBM. specification is there in which Los Angeles aberration value, aggregate impact value, flakiness index, all these values are given here for requirement of pavement layer. So these are the sizes of grade 4 coarse aggregate, size in range 90 to 40 mm, 63 to 40, 50 to 20. These are the size range, grade size range. Sieve size range is given and percentage passing of the sieve by weight is given. This is the standard passing sieve size weight. So grading required for WBM, these are the gradings required for grade A, this 12.5 mm screen. For grade B, 10 mm screen. Sieve sizes are 12.5, 10, 4.75, 0.15. For B it is 10, 4.75, 0.15. This is the range, 100, 90 to 100, 10 to 30, these are the range. Now construction procedure: binding the material first, then quantity of material for 10 mm thickness, it is given here. Then for 7.5 mm thickness, what is the coarse aggregate, what is the stone screening binding material, it is given. These are the specification for the WBM material. The construction procedure is preparation of foundation for WBM, then provision for lateral confinement, then spreading of the coarse aggregate, then rolling it, then application of screening, then sprinkling of grouting, then setting and drying. So these are the procedures: spreading, rolling, application of screening, sprinkling and grouting, setting and drying. Now construction of bituminous pavement material. So in this type of bituminous concrete are interface treatment like prime coat and tack coat, surfacing of the sealed coat, grouted penetration type or penetration macadam built of spray grout, premix or bituminous bond macadam, carpet, bituminous concrete, shield asphalt, mastic asphalt. Interface treatment: existing pavement layer is to be cleared, then prime coat has to be applied, then tack coat has to be applied, then bituminous surface dressing has to be. So this is single coat bituminous surface coating and two coat bituminous surface coating. So base course before rolling is, it looks like this, then after rolling it looks like this. So single coat bituminous surface coating is done as per this procedure. You can read out. Highway geometric design and highway alignment, next class we will see. Bankar.